Come now, O God of hope, make us one body. Come, O Lord Jesus, reconcile your people. Come now, O God of peace, make us one body. Come, O Lord Jesus, reconcile your people. Come now, O God of joy, make us one body. Come, O Lord Jesus, reconcile your people. Come now, O God of love, make us one body.
And he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Please stand as we are called to worship this morning. God of hope, God of peace, God of joy, God of love, abide with us today. We watch, we wait, for the Christ child is coming. Remembering the promises of yesterday, today, and tomorrow, we watch, we wait, for the Christ child is coming. Reveal your love to us as we journey to Bethlehem with the mystery of expectation. We watch, we wait, for the Christ child is coming. Please join me in prayer. God of hope, we give you thanks for the glimpses of joy and hope we witness throughout your creation. Bring hope where there is hopelessness. God of peace, we give you thanks for the reconciliation we know through you, be it with you or our sisters and brothers around us. Bring peace where there is peacelessness. God of joy, we give you thanks this morning especially that we find in the voices and in the playfulness of children. Bring joy where there is joylessness. God of love, we give you thanks for the love made known to us in this room. And we pray, O God, that you would be present here as we worship you. God of hope, God of peace, God of joy, God of love, help us to know you as we call upon your name this Advent season. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. I invite you to remain standing as we sing together hymn number 105, People Look East.
Thank you. even as we look and wait, we still too must confess our sin to the one whose mercy extends from generation to generation. Let us pray together the printed prayer in your bulletin. God of generations, like your promised Abraham, you promised to walk with us, to dwell with us, to be present with us. You promised to love us even when we cannot love ourselves and fail to love others. You give the gift of love to us without our earning or deserving. We confess, we accept, and need your forgiving love, yet fall short in offering that very love to the ones we turn away, saying there is no room in the inn. In this Advent time, renew in us the love you give and initiate our hearts to be spread the light of your love with abundant hope through glimpses of peace that bring joy to your people. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Amen. Sisters and brothers, by the faith of Christ, your sins are forgiven. Blessed be the God of our salvation, whose mercy is everlasting. Knowing God's love for us, let us share that love with one another as we pass the peace of Christ with our neighbors.
Good morning. It is with great joy we invite you and welcome you to worship this Sabbath day, the fourth Sunday of Advent. We welcome those who are visiting with us, and we are grateful for your presence here in worship. What a beautiful sight to see. We invite you to find the pew pads at the end of your pew to sign your name and pass it down so that we might greet one another by name when we depart our time today. We'd like to also extend welcome and a hello to our TV audience as they tune in this day for worship. As you might have noticed, today is a special day in the life of our congregation as our youngest disciples will proclaim the word of the living God for us. And for that, we are grateful. We want to remind parents that at the conclusion of our service today, if you will come and gather your child from up front, take them downstairs, and you may depart on your way. Young people, our youth, we are going caroling and out to lunch immediately following worship. If you will meet downstairs in Warner Hall, we will get the buses and come pick you up so you do not melt in the rain. This evening is a very special service, carols by candlelight, and we invite you to come and to join us in celebration of great music. The prelude will start at 5:45, so be sure to arrive early. We'd also like to extend a warm welcome and invitation to our Christmas Eve worship services. One will be held at 5 p.m. and a service at 11 p.m. We hope to see you there. We also hope to see you gathered in your Christmas pajamas and favorite Christmas sweater on Christmas Day when we will have worship at 11 a.m. So lots of time for us to give praise to the Prince of Peace this season. Please note, parents, the child care nursery during those Christmas Eve and Christmas Day services will be for 0 to 2-year-olds only. All other children we want here in this space so we can hear their tiny voices as we proclaim the birth of the Christ child. It is with great thanksgiving that we welcome a new member into the life of our congregation at the recommendation of Session. So Charlie Bailey, welcome. And we are excited for the ministry that we will be able to partner with you as we continue in life together. One more calendar item, friends. On January 8th, we will have a joint worship service in this space at 11 a.m., Our new head of staff, Reverend Michael Bailey, will be leading that worship service. And the sermon is entitled this: The Story Continues, But a New Chapter Begins. And so we hope that you will all gather back here that Sunday morning. As a church, the body of Christ, fellow brothers and sisters, we are invited to lift one another up in prayer. Connie Galt has gone home, and so continued prayers for her recovery. We continue to lift up the names of Margaret Bryant, Margaret Searcy, and Margaret Lackey. We continue prayers for Andy Dearman's family. And we also remember Audrey Smith this day as they are remembering the life of her uncle. With all being said, we, the body of Christ in this Advent season, have so much to be thankful for. God is with us and working with us and using us in amazing ways. So let us give back to God. Let us offer God our tithes and our offerings, and most importantly, our very selves.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy God, your love is magnified in the gift of your Son, whom you so freely share with us. Bless these gifts that we offer to lift up the lowly and fill the hungry. Remember all who suffer in this world, whether from injustice or sickness or grief, having confidence that nothing is impossible with you. Through Christ, with Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, we magnify you, Almighty God. Amen. Please be seated.
Our scripture reading for us this morning is found in the Gospel of Luke. Luke chapter 1, verses 46 through 56, found on page 57 of your pew Bible. Listen now for the word of the Lord. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in their thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, Abraham, and to his descendants forever." And Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our gospel story today is a story of how God's love showed up in the people of Mary, in Joseph, in the angel Gabriel, and in donkeys, and in cows, and even in the little drummer boy. And so, without further ado, may the word be proclaimed by the children of God as they show up and help us remember the promise of the Christ child for you and for me this Advent season. Come, Lord Jesus, come. And so that they may enter, let us join in singing hymn number 88, if you'll remain seated. O come, Emmanuel, let us lift our voices with hope, peace, joy, and love this day.
is Emmanuel and why do people want him to come?
Emmanuel is a Hebrew word that means God is with us. The people are calling for God to be with them.
Well, they also said something about Israel being in exile until the Son of God appears. What's up with that?
The Hebrew people, also known as Israel, had been in exile or sent away from their homeland. They had returned and were waiting on God to send them someone to save them, what they called a Messiah. And it turns out that God sent his Son as the Messiah.
God's Son was the Messiah and he sent him to be with the people? I'm confused. How did God do that?
Well, first, God sent a messenger angel named Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth to give a message to a young woman named Mary. Watch and listen.
And so Mary went to Joseph and told him she was with child. She told him of the visitation by the angel and the marvelous words spoken.
I bet Joseph didn't like that. He probably sent her away and had nothing else to do with her.
Well, Joseph was confused and probably angry. He made a plan to send Mary away. And then he fell asleep and had a dream where he was visited by an angel.
I'm confused again. What does naming a baby Jesus have to do with saving God's people from their sins?
The name Jesus is the Greek way of saying Joshua, and Joshua means one who saves or savior. The name was written as Jesus because the Bible was written in Greek.
How did you know that?
I learned it in Sunday school. You should come more. Now, back to the story. Joseph did just as the angel told him. He took Mary as his wife, and for the next 9 months, they prepared for the birth of their son. In those days, Caesar Augustus declared that everyone throughout the empire should be enrolled in the tax lists.
Caesar Augustus must have been a politician.
He wasn't exactly a politician. He was more like a dictator. After he gave the order for everyone to be put on the tax lists, then all the people went to their own cities to be registered. Since Joseph belonged to David's house, he went from the city of Nazareth in Galilee to David's city called Bethlehem in Judea.
But what was he going to do with Mary? Wasn't it about time for her to have her baby?
He took Mary with him, and she was very close to having her baby.
Have you any room? We have traveled very far from Nazareth and looking for a place to stay.
Are you someone important? A rich businessman? A celebrity? A king?
No, I'm just a simple carpenter.
I have nothing for you. I must hold my rooms for people more than the important likes of you.
Do you have any room?
What's your name? Do you have a reservation?
My name is Joseph, and this is my wife, Mary. I didn't know that we needed to have a reservation.
Are you kidding me? With all these people coming to Bethlehem, there are very few rooms available. I'm afraid I'm almost completely full. Try the inn across the street. Maybe they have some.
Please, do you have anywhere to stay?
Look, mister, we all have problems. I've got plenty of my own out this many years. Oh, Sarah,
Please, do you have any room at all?
I'm sorry, I'm completely full.
Do you have anything, anywhere I can stay?
No, I told you. I don't believe there's a single bed left in all of Bethlehem tonight. Everyone is here for the census.
Wait, Daddy, what about the stables? I just cleaned them this morning, and you always say we should help people.
Well, you're right. The stable is barely standing, but it's warm with animals, and you can rest in the hay.
Thank you for your kindness. God will bless you.
I only wish I had more to give.
Stop banging on that thing. I'm trying to sleep.
Leave the boy alone, Jake. You know he has nowhere to go. How can you sleep on a night like tonight when the stars are so beautiful? And besides, you're supposed to be watching the sheep, not sleeping.
It's beautiful. It's magical. It looks like a night when just about anything could happen.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Like a miracle.
Ha ha ha.
Well, it could, like the ones you hear about from the old days.
You and your imagination, those are just stories. They never really happened.
We don't know that for sure. After all, they are in the scriptures. They were miracles given to us by God.
Oh, come on, Amos. Waters parting, burning bushes, angels appearing out of the sky. Don't be ridiculous.
But it's part of our faith. If we don't believe in them, what else do we have?
Did you hear something?
Look!
Don't be afraid, for I hear the good news, which will bring great joy to all of you. Tonight in Bethlehem, your Savior is born, Christ the Lord. And this is what will prove it to you. You have found a baby, wrapped in linen cloth, lying in a manger in the stable.
Suddenly, a great army of heaven's angels appeared, singing praises to God.
Thank you.
miracle.
Well, what are you waiting for? Come on, let's go.
Where?
To Bethlehem. We must go meet our Savior.
I thought you didn't believe in miracles, Jake.
Well, a guy can change his mind, can he? Come on, let's go. You too, Aaron. You can play that drum for us as we go.
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in the city of Bethlehem, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? We have followed his star to this land." Hearing this, King Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star appeared.
Wait, I thought Caesar Augustus was in charge.
He was in charge of the whole Roman Empire, but the Roman Senate had elected Herod to be king of the Jews, and he didn't want any other king threatening him.
I will trick these visitors from the east into thinking that I'm with them, and then when they bring word, send out troops to slay this baby. I have heard of this child. Go and make careful search for him. And when you have found him, bring word that I may also go and worship him.
Amen.
Jake, look at all of these very expensive presents, and I have nothing to give.
Well, Aaron, why don't you play that drum of yours for him?
They told me, pa-rum-pum-pum, a newborn king to see, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, to lay before the king, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum. So to honor him, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, when we come, little baby, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, I have no gift to bring, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, I am a poor boy too, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, that's fit to give the king, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum. Shall I play for you, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, on my drum?
On that night, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us.
So the baby Jesus is God with us, Emmanuel.
Thank you.
us.